we're focusing very much on the casting process development for both blades and the bigger casing.
In the world of helicopters, manufacturing with precision and efficiency is paramount to success. So that brings up the question, which is superior, machining or casting? Let's start by first understanding what each of these processes really entails. Machining on paper is quite a simple process. All it involves is taking away material until you get the desired shape of the object you're trying to obtain. On the other hand, casting is where you take liquid metal, pour it into a mold, and then allow it to solidify into one solid complete piece.
We're focusing very much on the casting process development for both blades and the bigger casings. Over the course of the last week, our main focus has been on being able to produce the wax trees. So the trees that allow us to connect a bunch of the individual turbine blades that we want to a feeder, and then some sprues and little branches to feed molten metal into the cavities that we create for each of the blades.
So why is casting preferred for the manufacturing of things like gearbox casings? Stay tuned and you're gonna find out. Firstly, casting is much, much more economical. Let me explain. When machining something from solid, like a gearbox casing, which has a large surface area, but a very thin wall thickness, you end up with a lot of wastage of material. You're machining from massive billets, like the one beside me, but the actual product is not even using half of the material you initially started with. And this is a massive, massive waste and cost when it comes to manufacturing from solid. Casting allows you to have minimal wastage in terms of material. Now, along with Jace saying that we're gonna be casting the casings, you would have also heard him saying we're gonna be casting the turbine blades. And there is a really good reason behind that. Turbine blades are made out of super alloys, which makes them extremely, extremely durable, which in turn makes them very, very hard to machine. The material is just that tough, which is why casting is a much better option. You don't have to go through that extreme machining process. Now, like I just mentioned, machining turbine blades would be extremely hard. So hard, in fact, that you could only really do it on a grinding machine, which limits the geometry that you can machine, meaning that turbine blades with their intricate lines and sweeping curves would not be practical on a grinding machine, hence why casting is a better option.
So what we've done this week is we've machined up a little mold. So this is the mold, the wax tree gets poured into there as liquid wax, we allow it to dry and then out it comes. That can then be welded with a simple hot gun to connect the blades to it. And then once we've done all of that, we then use the wax tree and essentially dip this in a batter, yeah? Let it cool, add some sand, dip it into batter again, more sand, dip it into batter again, more sand, and then you eventually build up a ceramic shell, so something like this. And then what we've created here is essentially a fixture that, if you can see through there, can you see the ceramic shell inside? So that ceramic shell has got the cavity inside it that the wax produced. The wax has been burnt out, and then we pour the molten super alloy into there, and then by having these open areas out here, we can cool this very rapidly to get the crystal structure that we need in the blades. So we've done that this week, and then these will shortly be going off to cast another bunch of turbine blades, which we think will be the final production process. So really pleased with how that's going.
You must be thinking at this point, obviously casting is much better than machining. Well, before you jump to that conclusion, I need to admit something. Neither is quote unquote superior for production, because they each have their place for different things. For casting, gearbox casings and turbine blades are obviously the better option. But for things like machining, gears come into play. So each have their different use cases and are just as important in the process of making HX50. On that note, I'm gonna conclude this video about casting. It's been great showing you guys where we're up to with making our casting processes and what that's gonna look like, and also explaining what it's all really about. Stay tuned for the coming videos where you can see the completion of this process along with many, many other things that are to come. See you soon, guys.